morning. I'm not sure if everyone knows who we are, so just a quick introduction. My name is Christie Lightfoot, and this is my wife, Marissa Lightfoot. We like to say she's the manager of this arrangement, and I'm the PR person. But now the manager gets to speak. Good morning, everyone. This is definitely not what I do best. This is truly not my comfort zone, but you guys are my family now, so I feel that, testimonial stuff is really important. I just kind of want to briefly introduce myself. Like Christy said, my name is Marissa. I was actually born in Pahului, Maui, about 54 years ago. My family and I moved to the Philippines when I was 10 and spent about 6 years there. Grew up Catholic, did all the Catholic stuff, went to the Catholic school. But there was always a sense of yearning and just something missing, even though I was surrounded by my wonderful family. I had a huge family, grew up with a bunch of male cousins, so, very independent. Thanks to them, I was able to make decisions for myself. And, thankfully, I carried that role with my two beautiful daughters. I have two beautiful daughters that live in California, actually just recently visited us. And I have a grandson who's actually just turned 3. He is a beautiful boy. He has autism, but the times that I spent with him, I felt that there's definitely something that I wanted to do more for the people and for kids like him that live in their own world. That sometimes you're just very fortunate to visit. So I was very fortunate to spend time with him and be able to understand his world. And hopefully in the future, I can spend some time learning his world and all the stuff that, we can offer to children right now. But anyways, when my family and I moved to the Philippines, like I said, there was something missing within me. I then felt that there was a connection with God. I felt that everything that we do as a Catholic was just rehearsed, kind of like learned, not even, felt. So I knew that I was different. I knew that, there was something in me that goes beyond just, to be who I can be. I know that there was something that I can be, but obviously in a Catholic where it's not accepted or not recognized. So when my family moved to California when I was 16, kind of did all my Catholic, good Catholic girl, met a man that was truly a good man, married, had children, but then again, there was still something missing. So there was definitely a connection. And then one time I was telling my wife, Christy, and it was just felt when I moved to Texas 5 years ago for work. One time when I was walking my two dogs, it was a beautiful moonlit night, and it felt like God was calling me, and felt that there truly is something there for you. You've done what you had to do for your children, for your family. I think it's now that it's time for you to live your life. So 5 years ago, I told my kids, you guys are grown, you have your own life. Mom's gonna move to Texas, and I'm gonna follow my life, my authentic life. I'm gonna live my authentic life. too, because I was also raised Catholic, but my experience was a little different. It did feel real and authentic, and I did feel like I had the connection with God from little baby. I was born in Bayous of Louisiana and went to St. Joseph's Catholic Church, affectionately named St. Joe. Was baptized there, did my first communion, reconciliation, confirmation, was married there, baptized my own kids there. So it was definitely a huge, huge part of my identity. Not just the connection I have with God, but the connection I have with my community, the connection I have with my family, and the connection I have with my Catholic faith. However, like Marissa, that's where the story kind of takes the same kind of path of being a good Catholic girl and denying your true self for others. To make sure that you were the good girl, the good servant, the good daughter, even if you were lying to yourself. So for 28 years, I was married to a wonderful man who is an absolute wonderful father to our four kids. We have two biological children together who are now 27 and 28. In fact, Logan, both of them live in Alaska with my grandchildren. I have five. And Logan's birthday is today, King Kamehameha's Day. So, and then we adopted two more kids, and one is here, y'all know Taylor, and her brother Randy, who I just spoke to this morning, who is in boot camp for the Army currently. So, but it was at the point of teaching catechism for 10 years, being a homeschool mom for another 10 years, being a house cleaner at the church while we were in Alaska. It's in the St. Joe. We did move to Alaska, so big difference from the Bayous. But it was at that point in Alaska, something about the coldness, the rawness, it started to come out that God was calling me to be true. And in the disassimilation of my life, what felt like was imploding. Like Pastor Joseph says, nothing really is ever lost, just recreated. And a life was recreated. And this place, Oahu, I visited as a nurse, doing a travel nursing assignment back in 2004. And I applied to come back because I fell and left my heart here. And God would have it that He introduced me to my soulmate, who was also an island girl and wanted to come back home. And because of Marissa, because of God, because of you, we're home. And the first time that we saw this home, Marissa called Taylor to go get her TV shot for school. And she saw this beautiful place out here. And when we were coming back from the beach, we saw the flag. And so it was the first time that we said, ooh, we definitely need to try this church. And it wasn't until Eric and his family, Christy and Abby Everett, they met us at the Pride Festival and introduced us to themselves and to this church. And it's been home ever since. So thank you so much for welcoming us, for loving us, especially Taylor and I. When Marissa hasn't been here, it's been nice to have other people to lean on when you don't know anyone. So thank you all very much for the love and support.